So it is the week before Thanksgiving, which on the homestead means it's turkey time. So we did an experiment this year that we haven't told you about yet, because we weren't quite sure how it was going to work out, but we decided to try to raise some turkeys for Thanksgiving. And so this is Tom, and as you can see, he has turned out really well. And then our other turkey here, Turkey Lurkey, she's a little smaller, but it's, as I said, the weekend before Thanksgiving, so we are going to process Tom today. And so we weren't sure how this was going to work out. We've read a lot of things that said raising turkeys with chickens can be very dangerous because the chickens can carry a disease that's fatal to the turkeys. And it looks like at least our chickens have not been carrying that disease. So our turkeys are nice and healthy, and we are ready for Thanksgiving, or at least we will be in a couple hours. All right, so Tom has been dispatched. He did not quite fit in the cone, biggest cone we could find. So he's quite the big boy. He clocked me pretty good in the head while he was bleeding out. So he got one last kick in at me. We're gonna pluck him. So we've got a cooler over here with scalding water. As soon as he's done bleeding out, we're gonna scald him, and then we're gonna pluck him. All right, since we're gonna pluck him, we're gonna scald him first. We've got a cooler full of hot water. We've been getting it up to 170 to 200 boiling, so that hopefully it stays above 150. You need it above 150 so we can loosen the feathers. Go ahead and open that up. And of course, if the feathers don't come off, just put them back in for a little bit longer. All right, so Tom's processed. Other than the plucking, it's basically the exact same process as we use for the roosters. So if you want to learn more about how to process a chicken or a turkey, please see our other video. I'm going to put him into the cooler now and get his temperature down, and then we're going to start cleaning up for the day, I think. All right, so Tom is all done. Let's get him weighed. Our kitchen scale isn't gonna go high enough for him, so we had to get our bathroom scale.
Don't put it on until it says zero.
All right, and Verdict is 27.4 pounds. So he is as much as 9 of our chickens. why'd we waste all that time with the chickens?
All right, so we have been keeping Tom in this cooler because he is a big, big bird and would take up half of our fridge. We kept him in the cooler. We had some ice in here, and that kept him cool for the couple days we needed before preparations for Thanksgiving. This morning, what we did is we made a brine, and we will link to that recipe below. It's a recipe at a food web food site, so we'll just link to it. And it's just, you know, water, broth, salt, and some herbs, and you can see all the herbs and things. We put it in here, and then you're supposed to put in 8 cups of water and 8 cups of ice. Well, Tom's pretty big, so we ended up putting in more water, so the proportions weren't quite right, but we'll see how he tastes tomorrow. We did put in a little bit of ice, but it's cold enough out here on the deck that he's really probably fine without it, but better safe than sorry. And with this brine, they can sit in the brine for anywhere up to 24 hours, is what the recipe said.
All right, good morning. Happy Thanksgiving. It is about 6 in the morning, Thanksgiving morning. And we got Tom out and put him in the roaster. And of course, he doesn't fit. He's too big. And so we're going to try to get the legs off and see if we can manipulate him with the legs off and get him to fit. All right, so getting the legs off, we were able to sort of get him to fit. Now Mama Bear is going to cover him with a butter and herb mixture while I slice up some lemons and apples to put into the cavity.
I just softened a little bit of butter and added whatever herbs I have on hand, or whatever your preference is for your turkey. I know sage and thyme are quite common. I actually had a little bit of fresh oregano that I did. And so we'll just do that. I washed my hands beforehand, get the little pats of butter, and I like to spread it in between the skin and the meat because then that kind of traps it in there. And it just cooks down into the meat and crisps up the skin and makes the meat really nice and buttery and juicy.
In the back.
Oh,
so sorry, dear. All right, so we're just going to shove the apple. Well, I don't have to shove anything. The cavity's huge. We're going to drop the apples and the lemons into the cavity.
Now, these are not for eating. These are just to flavor the bird while
and
it's cooking.
It also flavors the broth a little bit, gives it a little bit richer gravy.
And it also helps keep the bird moister while it's cooking. But don't eat it.
Well, I mean, there's nothing wrong with it.
Well, there's
lemons are really sour.
The stuff that you cook in the cavity is a higher risk of contamination and not getting to the full temperature. And
yeah,
so it's
you
just
have to
not,
be aware of that.
It's just not safe. You want to put one more of each in there? Okay, so got it all prepped. So we're going to go ahead and turn it on to 350 and let it cook. We're approximating it's going to take about four and a half hours.
Five.
Six, maybe seven. we'll see. We've never cooked a bird this big before, so it's going to be an experiment. Plan is to eat around noon, so we've got about 5.5 hours, and we'll see if we make that or not.
The roasting pan quite often cooks it a little bit faster than our oven, And we like cooking it in the roasting pan because it gives us a nice dedicated spot that's just for the turkey, and it leaves our oven free for other Thanksgiving goodies.
Plug that in.
Yes.
Yep. All right.
So turkey's underway.
At Barely Homesteading, we want to wish you a happy Thanksgiving. Thank you for your support this year, and as always, remember to use it up, wear it out, make it do, or do without.
Bye.